Why can't you just tell me the fucking truth? Stop lying. Stop being a politician for one fucking minute. Can't you just be my dad?
Rachel, that woman you saw, that wasn't my mistress. That was your mother.
What?
What did I say when we looked at the family photo?
She's blonde.
What did I say about... Oh, I guess Rachel dyed her hair then? Because something's not adding up here.
You know, my first thought was that, oh, it's just her mum in disguise. And then I was like, hang on a minute. Wait, what? Huh?
Is that the end of the episode?
No, it can't be.
It's gotta be. It's gotta be. How do you carry on from that? It's the end of the episode, yeah.
This is a great song.
You're acting like you like it. You're acting like you know it.
I do. Shadows settle on the. Can't remember the lyrics. It's from one of my favorite series. It's called Argyle.
Oh, okay. I thought this was a song made for the game.
Destroy the middle. It's a waste of time.
Is that Damon?
From the perfect start to the finish line.
He's looking at the ledger.
Still breathing. You're the lucky ones.
Oof.
Because most of us are heaving corrupted. Setting fire to our inside.
Is that Victoria?
Mm-hmm.
Collecting names of the lovers that went wrong. The lovers that went wrong.
Oh yeah, because she didn't get to do it.
Oh, she was never going to, she was never meant to do it, really.
Oh, Joyce.
Oh, Joyce. I need to know Samantha's deal.
And if you're in love, then you are the lucky one. Cause most of us are bitter over someone. Setting fire to our insides for fun. To distract our hearts from ever missing love.
This wildfire is the storm in life. Mm. It's like, yeah.
The approaching storm.
I am the storm that is approaching.
You go to keys too much.
That was the song from Devil May Cry, actually. Okay, cool. You took the blame. 71% of people took the blame for Rachel.
Mm-hmm.
63% of people emptied their pockets out of David at David's request. 66% of people stayed with Mikey. And you asked Rachel, many people asked Rachel for a kiss. 12% of people asked Rachel to get a tattoo. I don't know why this, oh wait, hold on. Is that a hydrate? That is a hydrate.
I'll hydrate from a drop.
I've actually got water this time.
Oh, I should have made a coffee. Just thought about that.
You intended to go to the 49% of people pretended to go to the play with Elliot. 24% of people refused to start over. Most people would agree to start over with David.
Oh, okay.
Interesting. 68% of people put the singing man on the dashboard. So 96% of people didn't pay off your debt to Frank.
We didn't, did we?
That's because we did already.
Oh.
I'm thinking that's what it means.
Well, no, because like he gets us to do something. So was that just...
No. So there's a scene... There's a... In that scene when he's asking you to go and
yeah.
He's also meant to, I think he's also meant to ask you about, hey, the money you owe me, by the way. But we'd already paid him.
Yeah.
Yeah. You didn't tell Steph that Rachel was single. 87% of people did.
Ooh.
31% of people, only 31% of people returned Drew's money to him.
Yeah. That's interesting.
Interesting. You told Samantha to help Nathan. Most people did that. No. Most people didn't give Samantha advice at all.
Oh, probably because they didn't
talk to her after the eavesdrop. Yeah. I need to sneeze. You confronted Victoria before the play. There's other ways you can go. This you encourage Victoria before the play. You tricked Victoria before the play. You discourage Victoria before the play.
I wonder how that scene like runs out. If like Rachel Amber drinks the drink.
I don't think you could. Maybe, I don't know. I think Rachel has to perform.
Yeah.
And you because you see, you can't let, I don't think
there's
a way.
How does that change if she was to drink the drink? Like, if there's an option for
there isn't,
like,
there isn't.
No?
Because the first two options are distract Victoria tell Rachel. Been marinating for a year. How was Sea of Stars? I haven't played it since I beat it. And actually, while we were on break, I was on Twitter and I saw an announcement that Sea of Stars is getting a free update on November 14th called Dawn of Equinox. I have it here. It's what I was reading when you came back.
Mm-hmm.
On November 12th. So getting a new update that's going to include local co-op, revamped combat 2.0, a revamped prologue. So the prologue's not going to be a drag. Difficulty presets, a speedrunner mode, a new cutscene, and other quality of life improvements, which is great for people who haven't played the game already. but I have, so we will be getting back onto Sea of Stars once the actual DLC comes out. You told Rachel you'd like to go to New York. 30% of people said that. Most people chose Los Angeles. Most people did not attack James at dinner. Instead, Rachel would attack James.
Mm.
Okay. Hell is empty. Hey. Hey. All right.
Where's it going to start off of, though?
You're adopted. Wait. No, you're not adopted. What happened with then? What's going on? Why doesn't she know?
I want to tell you all of it. But are you sure?
Stop. I mentioned because there was another Chrono Trigger-like game show. Wait, it might be the game that Levan was talking to me about. Hold on. He sent me a message about a game. That he was like, hey, we should stream this. Like we did with Chained Echoes. There's a link to something. What was it? Give me a moment. Threads of Time? Was that it?
Yep.
Yes. So. fun fact about Threads of Time, real quick. Sorry. So I've been following Threads of Time's development for quite a little bit. And I actually was going to pitch a battle theme. Well, I was actually going to pitch myself to be a composer for that game. And I made like a sort of like work in progress sort of like concept battle theme, because I saw a GIF of all four of their main characters and their battle and their idol battle poses.
I think I remember you saying about this.
I might have showed you this, maybe. Who knows?
I think you showed me the idol poses. I don't know if you showed me the music to go alongside of it.
Potentially. So I'm going to play it now real quick, actually. But I need to find the GIF. Threads of Time. Oh, this would be weird. Threads of Time. There we go. Yeah, no, I've been following their Twitter account for years now. And I saw the trailer and it looks absolutely fucking fantastic. And it absolutely will be streamed to this channel. Wait, is this replies? I need media.
You clicked on replies as well.
Yeah. Ah! That's loud. Where's media?
That's it, no, middle one.
Hold on, let's go over here. Right, so is this one? It wasn't this one. There's a new character there, but yeah, we can use this. So this is what I composed. Like, it's not mixed or anything. It's called Thursday Time Battle, but work in progress. I composed it while I was looking at this because for some reason it just inspired me. Yeah. And then it pretty much just loops around like that, pretty much. So I made that like a few months ago to pitch to the developers. But I ended up not doing so. I just didn't get around to doing it. Because when you pitch to developers, you also got to find out, you got to do your research and find out whether or not, well, find out how far they are into development and whether or not they've already got a composer. Still don't know if they've got a composer. The music you hear in the trailer could be just like a trailer music. But I'm sure at this point they've got a composer, so
I want to be Double Sword Man.
Double Sword Man?
Yeah.
Have you seen the trailer?
No.
Game looks fucking phenomenal.
I was just like looking at the characters like, oh, which one looks like something I'd vibe with? Like two swords? Absolutely. It's just like Uzui.
So this is what the game looks like now. Like this is the thing now.
It looks
gorgeous.
Oh.
And they've got that like HD 2.5 style from Octopath. Yes,
yeah,
Octopath-ish.
It looks so cute.
Is this the trailer? I'm sure I remember the trailer being longer than that. Wait, hold on. How long was the trailer on YouTube? That is an app for Honkai. That is an ad for Honkai Star
Rail. My dailies?
Yeah, there's a longer one on YouTube. Let's go here. Threads of Time. I was catching up on Castle Super Beast. There we are. It looks fantastic.
I saw you long before your quest began, hero. I saw you before you threw open the doors of time and space and turned the world on its head. Let me show you a glimpse of what I saw.
Yes, pirates. It looks absolutely beautiful.
Prepare to remake history.
That looks so cool. I love that.
Yep. So, it looks fucking fantastic. You shared something in the Discord. Is that for me to look at now or later? I'm looking at it now. What is this?
Fishing. Cheese? Fucking love
cheese. Is that fucking chain? Did they add chain? They add. Fishing into Chained Echoes.
Is cheese one of the bait options?
Yes.
If I was a fish, 100%. 100%. I'd be like, oh my God, cheese. Oh.
That is cracked.
Oh, I love cheese.
Wait, when did they add that? Oh, I gotta look at this game again now. Oh, hell yeah. Speaking of Chained Echoes and Sea of Stars and all these and Levan and RPGs and stuff like that, fun fact: Levan is actually coming to visit this weekend.
Yeah,
so he's coming Thursday night, and he'll be leaving like Sunday evening. So we will be streaming on Friday or Saturday. I don't know what yet. It'll be probably like a one-off. We'll find something. I might get him to stream. I might stream the Metaphor ReFantazio demo and get him to play it. Either Friday or Saturday, Levan will be in this chair. And yeah, we'll be playing a JRPG of some sort. But yeah, no, cool, sick. Yeah, there's a time is
be here neat.
Chloe stays. Whatever you have to say to me, Chloe has to say to me. Has to hear whatever words I'm saying. Of I don't course. Know.
Words are difficult.
Words are difficult indeed.
That matters. Rose is my wife and your mother. But the woman you saw at the Overlook, her name is Sarah.
I already know.
Your birth mother.
Okay.
Why are we only just letting this? Why was he snogging her?
Yeah, so yeah, like, okay, great, but why were you kissing your ex-wife?
Yeah, the just because you're dropping this bombshell.
I said ex-wife, not necessarily. Why were you kissing your male after squeeze?
Everything, Rachel. Everything I've shielded you from for so long. But the truth can be hard to look at. Is this really something you're ready for?
Well, like 15, 16?
Yeah, 16.
Okay. I would have told... Mm.
Chloe. I'm right here. Good. I need you.
So obviously Sarah is going to be the last person in the thingy. Definitely, absolutely not a meth lab. Wait, what? Oh, wait, hold on.
Those were the previous ones.
Land of the Freaks, torture schedule, portrait of the survivors.
Daily dick pics.
Greasy gunk, daily dick pics, snapbox, clean campus, brotherly limb, DA's desk, unheeded warning.
Brotherly limb?
Ooh. Oof. I don't like that.
That's either to do with, like, Rachel Amber having a brother or...
Mike and Drew.
Yeah, one of them losing something. We graffiti them.
When I was in high school, there was one person everyone adored.
Oh, she the Rachel Amber of your time?
Her friends. Sarah was everyone's favorite. Every boy wanted to date her.
He's saying this all in front of his current wife.
Mm-hmm.
When she picked me. Sometimes, I think that's what kept me blind for so long. She was so alive. So passionate about everything. Early on, though, I realized I wasn't enough for her. While the rest of us were pursuing college, careers, families, Sarah wasn't looking for any of that. She was looking for escape. When Sarah became pregnant, I thought it would solve everything. And it did. For a little while. Becoming your father was the greatest moment of my life. There was so much love, but I was still blind. However much she loved you then, wasn't enough. For Sarah, the need to escape was always there. For over a year, I tried to help her. I made myself believe that she was still a good person. That no matter what happened, she would never do anything to hurt you. I was wrong.
Ooh.
Eventually, I saw her for who she really was. A destructive person. Someone who could never be satisfied. Anyone or anything, even the love of her own daughter. I was desperate. I didn't know what to do. So I made a choice. I was never going to let her harm you again.
So what is this?
What you saw at the Overlook, Rachel.
Seems like you went in for it.
We kissed.
He did. He's got his hands on her, like...
My life. It was a kiss. Goodbye. I told her. And I was happy for her. That she felt like she'd gotten her life together. Finally. But she didn't get to... just decide one day to be a mother.
Not after what she'd done. Not after all the people she hurt. All the lives she destroyed. I told her she'd been given the greatest gift in the world. The chance to be your mother. And she squandered it. It pained me to hurt her like that. But I'd do it again. And again. And again, to keep you safe.
So that was the first time you've seen her or spoken with her in 15 years?
No. I send her money. Every single month. It's
sounds like Rose knows this.
Arrangement.
But now she wants to see me?
Yes. But Rachel, it cannot be.
You think you have the right to decide that for her?
When I left Sarah, when I took Rachel away, I truly believe I saved her life. And I will continue to protect her no matter what.
But maybe she's different now. I mean, people change, right?
Maybe so. But consider that for 15 years, she's preferred that money to you.
Rachel. I think I need to lie down.
I think I need to start another fire.
She didn't start the fire.
Group chat.
Oh, that's a lot of right reading. Why wouldn't you tell? Why?
That's so weird.
Why? I hate that for them.
Like, we're just going to skip over that entire fucking...
Rachel and Chloe, where are you guys? We're at the Tempest cast party. I already texted Rachel like 8 times.
Hey, I don't think we're making it.
Chloe, you should come. Yeah, Chloe, you did awesome, babe. Hey, Chloe, great job tonight.
Oh, it was Brooke. Thanks, I can't.
But you were amazing. I'll even admit that Mr. Keaton seemed a little disappointed when I arrived. Seriously, just come. Bring Rachel.
Sorry, guys. Aw, look at them.
They're also, like...
Unfortunately, we're having a moment.
I can't leave Rachel to deal with this alone.
Sorry. He goes to a park. He kisses his...
Ex.
Somehow his wife knows about this, so I'm guessing he told her, potentially, because she wasn't like, she'd just like go, you kissed her, what? Like.
She's surprisingly okay with this.
Yeah.
If she didn't know. What can you say about a woman so mysterious her own daughter never heard of her until now? From what James told us, Sarah is a drug addict who got herself mixed up in all sorts of crazy shit. And by drugs, I mean OD and end up dead in an alleyway drugs, not smoke a bowl and watch anime. When Rachel was a baby, Sarah would get high when she was supposed to be looking after her. Things got so fucked up that James finally had to take Rachel away. The funny thing is, even as James talked about all the horrible things Sarah had done, he still seemed, I don't know, fixated, I guess? You could see the power she had over him. Actually, when he was talking about how beloved and magnetic Sarah used to be, I couldn't help but think of Rachel. I wonder if James sees that too. Maybe it's what makes him so afraid of her. Anyway, now Sarah is in Arcadia Bay looking to meet Rachel. After years of taking James' money to stay away, suddenly she wants a relationship with her daughter. James seems skeptical. When Rachel, I can't even imagine what Rachel must be going through.
Also, why wouldn't you tell your, like, daughter, hey, this isn't your actual mum, but, like, we'll tell you when you're older. Like, at least you'd have an idea.
It's the classic you're adopted story, isn't it? I think they used to think the strangest thing about the Ambers was how normal they were. They seemed like a bad 90s sitcom family, and I did my best to play the part of the wacky yet lovable best friend. Yet, I did tag a newspaper picture of James on the fridge, but only because his face looked so stupid. The goal was to get in and out of there without causing a scene, so we could make our escape. About that. Turns out I couldn't just sit back and let Rachel's cheating father act all high and mighty. I put his smug ass in place and even turned Rachel's mum against him. Then Rachel snapped. I guess she just can't stand the lying anymore. She told her mum about James making out with that woman. Everyone started yelling, and the next thing I knew, Rachel was going full destruction on the table. That's when the truth finally came out. Rachel's mom equals not her mom. Rachel's real mom equals makeup woman. Mine equals blown. Chloe the wacky yet lovable.
I don't understand why people get glass tables. They're just going to break. Like, Katie's got one in her uni house.
Yeah.
That's not going to be in one piece by the end of the uni year.
I mean,
someone's going to fall into that. Someone is.
There's going to be new context. Now that a new episode and that scene's happened, everything's going to be... All the things that we looked at before is going to have new dialogue. Good.
Rachel only knew half the truth when she set that fire. What if she'd known everything?
Yeah. New contextual stuff. For example, this.
Whoa. Sarah Gearhart is a known associate of that psycho who attacked Drew. Then again, so is Frank. The Tempest show feels so far away now. This is so painful to look at.
I've actually gotten used to Chloe's voice. Like, this different voice actress.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This seems like a James and Rose bookshelf. I can't imagine Sarah here instead.
Neither. We'll look at James, talk to James in a bit.
It's the fact that he was like, yeah, it was a goodbye kiss. I haven't seen her in 15 years, though.
Hard to argue that Rachel would have had a better life with Sarah. But does that make what James did right?
It's a sticky one still.
Can't believe I was feeling goofy enough to draw that just a few hours ago.
Yeah, that table's done for.
Holy shit. Rachel completely destroyed that table. I guess there's worse things than growing up around fancy stuff like this.
All right, let's chat to Rose.
See what she's got to say.
I can't even imagine how she must be feeling. Hey, Mrs. Amber.
I think it's Rose at this point. Hearing everything.
Okay, Rose.
Did you see the thing on the wall where it's like the more things you learn in life, the happier you'll be?
Is that what it says?
Yeah.
No, more things you learn to like.
Okay. Yeah,
I was about to take a screenshot. I was going to be so crazy. I thought it said
more things you learn in life. I mean,
anything?
That's very kind of you. Could you get out the broom for me? It's in the breezeway.
The what way?
The breezeway. Fancy people call probably a garage. No, wrong way.
Where's she?
Left.
Oh.
There.
The fuck is a breezeway? Wait, hold on. Shut.
Hey. Cool graphic. Rachel was really getting rid of this?
Let's see what breezeway is.
Wait, can I take the shirt? I can take the shirt.
A roofed outdoor passage as between a house and a garage.
Oh, sure, Chloe.
Okay.
Rachel was
right about the garage.
Anyhow.
Thanks.
So we've got a new shirt so we can wear it. So obviously, I think we change shirts every each chapter, each episode, so we're going to change into that probably at some point. Broom, 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 broom. I got it from the room. Let's sweep the mess together. Mm-hmm.
I'm really quite glad that you're here.
Thanks.
Yeah.
But why?
While Rachel's dealing with all of this, it's a relief to know she can talk to you. How are you doing, Chloe?
How you doing?
How am I doing?
Your generation loves to talk about how awkward different things are. Well, this must be pretty awkward, I'd imagine.
Better than Rachel. Yeah.
Rachel's the one who's really upset.
She has every reason to be. There are many painful things about Rachel's past, including my own role in hiding the truth.
Doesn't matter how painful it is. You don't lie to someone you love.
You might be right, but can any of us really know what we would do in his situation? He's been a devoted father for 15 years. I know he loves Rachel more than anything.
I'm surprised you're defending him after what he did at the Overlook.
It might be hard for you to understand, but after 13 years of marriage, I'm not threatened by what happened.
You're right. I don't understand.
You don't have to worry about me.
Why does she sound so robotic? James.
Rachel's the one who needs you right now.
Do you think Sarah is dangerous?
I've never met her, so I don't know. But I'm inclined to trust my husband.
I'm inclined to trust my
husband. Oh, you talking about Rose? Yeah, yeah, she sounds terrible.
Yeah.
Rachel's extremely fortunate to have him as her father.
Thanks.
Thank you, Chloe.
Yeah, the delivery on that was
like them trying to be like, oh, I'm sad. And
yeah, but it was very, it was very wooden.
Yeah.
All right, James, we'll go on.
He don't have a newspaper this time.
This must be hard for you too, Mr. Amber.
It could be far worse. My biggest fear is that Rachel will try to meet Sarah. I've dreaded it.
So that's why you never told her?
You have no idea what pain Sarah's caused. Her addiction has led her to do terrible things. I don't want Rachel to go through any of that.
What are you afraid Sarah would do?
I don't understand. Are you afraid that Sarah would do something to Rachel?
I don't think she would deliberately harm anyone. But addicts can cause tremendous harm without meaning to.
Yeah. But Rachel's not a baby anymore.
Listen to me. Sarah brought criminals and drug dealers into our home. She put Rachel in serious danger just to chase her habit.
Do you think Sarah is involved with any of the drug dealers around?
We know she is.
It wouldn't surprise me if she were.
You know she is.
She is. Chloe.
There's a far out behind us.
Trusts you more than anyone else right now.
Is this where you ask me to manipulate Rachel into doing what you want?
That is a fair question.
I ask you to do as your conscience dictates. But please, put my daughter's safety first.
That is something I will always do.
She's so young. You are too. But I know you've experienced loss.
Nah, this guy was chatting shit like not even half an hour ago.
He was.
I'll do what I can. I care about her too, you know?
I know.
You okay there?
Thank you.
Just taking my shoes off.
Wait. Let's go upstairs. Actually, nah, you're fine. We're gonna have a choicey choice soon, I bet. About what to do about Sarah.
I mean, we've got a visitor. At some point.
Mm.
That has to be a choice. Oh, I used to have those stars.
This is Do-Si-Do. Oh, that star?
No, the glow-in-the-dark ones. Did you not see them at all?
I was looking at a sticker.
I'll point them out in a minute. If I see them again. They're just like little plastic stars that I used to stick on my ceiling.
Oh, they glow in the dark?
Yeah.
Okay.
Rachel? I need some way to show Rachel that I'm here for her.
Ah, yes, an emergency kit.
Where are the stickers up there? Wait, where?
On the wall by the bed.
Oh, yeah. Corkboard.
Rachel has so many inspirations, she can barely keep them all contained.
Land of the Freaks torture schedule. Okay.
Makes sense that Rachel needs two signs to contain her awesomeness. I shall call her Lion Crab from now on.
So she's into astrology. Wait, yes, astrology, not astronomy.
Rachel even knows how to make a dinky lamp look cool. Rachel's surrounded by so much love, yet she seems so alone.
Break a leg from mom and dad. Nightlight. Turn on the nightlight.
Ah, it's pretty.
This light needs more light.
We need to turn off the light. Hold on.
What I could find around here to brighten up that nightlight.
To brighten what? Huh?
Just turn the other lights off. Turn the
light, other light off.
Rachel even knows how to make a dinky lamp.
Turn the other lights off.
Bro, I swear you don't. Anyway, okay, we'll figure it out.
Needlepoint.
The yin and badass yang of Rachel Amber. We were so close to making our break last night. Now, I don't know.
I don't know what I was expecting from Rachel Amber's room, but it wasn't this.
No, I was expecting a bit more emo-y.
Is there a section on how to walk fours through batshit crazy family drama? No?
What's an emergency kit for? Can I look at it?
Emergencies.
Well, safe. Milk?
It's not green.
It's water. Water, first aid kit, and a torch. And yeah, right, it's not green.
I love it if she just shone the light over in Rachel Amber's direction. She's like, wake up! Chloe, I'm leaving the door unlocked in case you don't have your key. Please come home. Doesn't matter that it's after curfew.
Well, I can't right now.
Please.
Right. Flashlight.
What's she gonna do? But it's not battery powered. It's
I know how I'm just like milling about it. Oh.
Ah.
Mm-hmm. I love how she's just milling about in her room while she's like upset.
Did she just stick that in the back of her trousers?
Yeah, it's the classic video game. I have this thing. It goes a hammer space behind me.
Kitchen sink? No problem.
Yeah. Alright, so I have a thing.
You have a thing.
There was some way to make this brighter.
I've already done it. Now I can...
Explore.
Where do I put it?
I don't know, have a look at the other side of the wall. Over there.
Maybe. Let's see. Drawer.
I know something Miss Arcadia doesn't.
That's not what I was looking at, but sure. How could anyone read that?
I can't. That's it's too close together.
Yeah. Like, I'm shocked that this went through, that's terrible to read.
See, that's fine.
That's terrible.
That's terrible, but the other one's fine. I would not want to
read that. Dear Miss Arcadia, what's the real deal with that fire north of town? And when is it going to come down here and incinerate us all in this fiery hug of death? Ask him for a friend. First. No, didn't the fire start the day after the firewalk was there? This is a strange one, friend. ABFD sources say they've never seen anything like it. No idea where it came from, no idea why it's lasted this long. Total mystery. Time to put your tinfoil hats on and start speculating. There's a dragon with matches that's loose in the town. Prescott's like 50% serious. While only 50, Prescott's the shadiest shit. You really put this past them? They probably had some incriminating evidence to burn, or better yet, bodies. Not to mention the chemtrails they drop all over town. Highly flammable. Occam's razor, people. Just some kids getting high in the woods. And for the weirdness, this town's weird. What else is new? But why male models? We are built on Indian burial ground, are we not? Native people's burial ground. And no, we're not. Burn, get it? Cool, sick. Planner. Wait, hold on. Have I missed one already?
Nah.
No.
Nah.
Torture schedule's gotta be this.
I think Rachel could...
Yeah, because it's a planner. Subject. Schedule.
Yeah, but that's the second one.
So was there one downstairs that we could have done?
How can I have missed one already?
That's the one.
I should get it. Graffiti 2! Let me out! Let me out!
FBI, open up!
Oh my god, I can't believe I missed one already.
Not a proper gamer now. You missed it.
Oh, what's even the point? What's this?
Save the flowers.
This is relevant to your interests?
Oh, but they're roses.
That's what I realise. We're quite quiet on the mic.
Hmm?
Oh, look. Anyway, I tried to go through the drawer the first time. There we go. Oh.
Huh?
I could get grades like this. I just don't want to.
Love that. Same.
Just don't wanna.
Even you, Willie, couldn't come up with the tragedy Rachel's going through.
Rachel. She said Willie.
I wonder if it's her way of feeling connected.
Man, is that another graffiti?
Yes, it is.
Anywhere but here.
This is the bit where you're like, is this the
land
third
of
one?
The freaks?
I'm or the first one.
Wait, can you imagine? Can you imagine if it was the third one? I think that's the first one. It makes sense.
It's got to be the third one.
It's got to
be the third one.
Maybe I can make the world a less scary place.
Something Rachel said.
On stage, I think Rachel said.
She's sleeping.
No, she's got her eyes open.
She's watching you tag her shit. The corners of the world of mere pro are mere prologue. Yeah, baby. The corners of the world are mere prologue. I remember her saying that.
I don't. She spattered a lot of Shakespearean stuff that kind of just went over.
Actually, that line actually goes hard. The corners of the world are mere prologue. Remind me to.
Ooh. Is that Nathan?
Better not be. It sure is.
Nathan hang out sometimes, but it still seems hard to believe.
Right. Stars. Oh, her eyes are open. See, you don't look around. It's like people just like to like hardline the story and go straight to the objective. But when you don't, when you look, take the time to look around, you miss moments like this.
Stars.
Check it out.
She likes stars. So yes, this is beautiful. This is cute. This is...
They're not actual stars though. It's just lights on a ceiling.
It is just lights on a ceiling.
I like it. I've always loved stars.
You'd be terrible at this.
Me?
It reminded
no.
me so much beauty out there.
Rachel would be like, the stars are so pretty, and you'd be like, they're not stars, they're little lights.
Yeah, go outside and look at actual stars.
Wow, you really said touch grass.
But it's in front of us.
We came back from the night out.
I can't hear you.
Huh?
I can't hear you.
Well, we came back from the night out on Saturday.
Mm-hmm.
All I kept doing was stars.
I've already been for millions of years.
But that's what I did.
Mm-hmm.
On the walk back, I'd like look up. I've learned my mistakes now. Yeah. I look up, and I was like, oh.
But that doesn't make them any less beautiful, right?
I don't know. If they're not even real, then what's the point?
Exactly.
It's all lies. Everything.
The stars aren't real.
My entire life. My dad. My mom. If I can even call her that anymore. And that other woman, my real mom, she's the biggest lie of all. I can't trust any of them. I think you're the only one in the world I can trust.
I'll take it. Even elimination.
Good. I wore this bracelet my entire life. I never even asked why. Never even thought about it. Somehow, I think I always knew. Even when I didn't know. That my real mother was gone.
So for a second I was like, are you asking me to press B to leave? She's in the middle of fucking pouring her eye out. Like, what the fuck?
Yeah, she's like, okay, I'm done with this. I'm going home.
I'm going to the cast party. You coming?
I've graffitied what I want. Now I'm off.
I've got my tags. Alright.
You're just a video game character to me.
I can't let the music sit because otherwise copyright.
Oh.
She came here. For me, I think I need to see her. Is that wrong?
Nope.
Of course not. But it might be tough to track her down.
Yeah, that's true. Luckily, I've got my secret weapon. But what if we can't find her? So, like, I can ask my dad. I have no idea where to start.
Frank?
I think, yes. I know what to do. I'll call Frank and get him to connect us to her.
You do that?
I'll give it a shot.
Of course, even if we know where she is, we need a way to get to her. I can't just ask my parents for a ride.
Don't worry. I've got that one covered too.
You do?
Yep. In fact, anything you could come up with, I'll handle it.
I know you will. But even if we find her, how will I talk to her? What do I say?
You know.
My dad died. I was worried I wouldn't know how to talk to him anymore. But somehow, when we speak, I always know what to say.
When you speak?
In my dreams. He's there. And It's so real. It's almost like it's another part of my life. It used to be the only part that mattered. I've never told anyone about that. Weird, huh? Rachel?
I was just thinking. Maybe I was wrong before. Who cares if the stars are dead? As long as we can still see them, that means they're real. To us. Right?
Right.